amongst the rubbish tips of Netza, they're building a Catholic cathedral. The poor people are paying for it themselves. It will be an expression of their faith in a religion that's taken sides in the cause of conservation. But not everybody's sure which side it's really on.
Next week, some of Britain's top company directors launch a campaign aimed at turning businesses green. And in Nature, Michael Burke will be examining whether this message is being heard by industry in Britain and Germany. Nature next Monday at 8:30, with a repeat on Wednesday, here on 2. 800 years ago, a notorious massacre took place at Clifford's Tower.
What happened here in York in 1190 was just one episode in an extraordinary but little-known story. A cautionary tale of how society uses and abuses the outsider. Nowadays, as the result of the Second World War and the Holocaust, we tend to associate anti-Semitism chiefly with Central and Eastern Europe. Some of its most virulent origins, however, are much closer to home.
Timewatch, tonight at 8:10, on 2. Now, Patrick Stewart guides the Enterprise and a nervous crew to the last outpost in this week's story of Star Trek, The Next Generation.
Captain's log, stardate 41386.4. We're in pursuit of a starship of Ferengi design. Our mission is to intercept and recover a T9 energy converter which the Ferengi stole from an unmanned monitor post on Gamma Tauri 4. A theft which automatic scanners recorded, providing us with the long-awaited opportunity to make close contact with a Ferengi vessel. If we succeed in this chase, it will be Starfleet's first look at a life form which, discounting rumor, we know almost nothing about.
There she is. Enlarge.
What is their course?
They're now angling through that solar system, Captain.
Identify.
Listed as Delphi Ardu, sir. 11 planets unexplored.